Hi, I'm Sarah Ryrie, and you're watching MediaPlex Live at 1. Although technically the games begin today, the 2014 Winter Olympics opening ceremony will be aired live on Friday. An estimated 3 billion people worldwide are expected to tune in. We all know it has been cold with record-setting minus temperatures that not only affect us, but our pets as well. Reporter Mandy Matthews tells us what we can do to help.
Whether they're from the barnyard or the backyard, animals have been suffering through the extreme weather of 2014. We have experienced record low temperatures this year, making it nearly impossible to step outside. Although there is not much the Humane Society can do for the strays of Windsor, OSPCA officer Amy Reham said she wouldn't be able to turn a blind eye. And the same goes for many Windsorites who have reported over 60 cases to the Humane Society about animals outside for long periods of time. 3 dogs have been seized so far this year due to insufficient care. Reham says,
"It's pretty simple. You know, if you're going to have a dog outside, you need to have an adequate shelter. It's simple.
PetSmart employee Angela West owns 2 dogs and admits to learning a thing or two along the way.
Like a lot of other people, I had no idea what I was doing. I had a dog and I didn't really know how to care for him. It's really important for you to know because everybody makes mistakes, but the moment you start doing the wrong thing and your dog becomes overweight or has an injury because you don't know what you're doing kind of makes you feel bad and it becomes like really sad for everybody."
Doctor of Veterinary Medicine Chuck Firth says much like humans, animals will experience the same symptoms caused by extended periods of time in extreme weather.
Farm animals, make sure they have a building, a protected building that they can be in, so at least they can be somewhat protected from the wind and the drafts that are associated with the cold weather. Pet owners, basically make sure if you're leaving your pets outside, you know, leave them out for brief periods of time, perhaps be out there with them, and short stints back in the house as soon as possible.
During the winter, we try to avoid going outside as much as possible. However, animals still need their daily exercise.
Instead of bringing your pet outside for a half an hour, Dr. Firth recommends taking them outside in intervals of 5 to 10 minutes, 4 to 5 times a day. Speaking of which, this guy needs to go inside. I'm Mandy Matthews reporting for MediaPlex News Now.
On Wednesday, the health unit issued a cold weather alert for Windsor and Essex County. Temperatures are expected to drop to minus 17 degrees Celsius Thursday night and negative 16 degrees Friday night. For many University of Windsor students, going out on a weeknight to catch a movie is almost impossible, but a student is bringing the cinema to them. Sean Preville has the story.
UN Cinemas opened last Thursday, bringing the movie theater experience to the University of Windsor. Michael Anthony Ferrato said he came up with the theater idea because he wanted to enhance the student experience.
We're trying to provide a great experience to students who live on campus and can't necessarily make it out to, you know, the movies at the mall or, you know, other places on a random weeknight. And, you know, we're making it affordable, so it's really accessible to them.
Starting with Rush last week, UN Cinema's next film tonight is sure to rip the screen apart.
What they did to me, what I am, can't be undone.
For only $3 a student and $5 for general admission, moviegoers can enjoy the continuing saga of Wolverine. Doors will open at 7 p.m., with the show starting at 7:30 in Erie Hall, room 1120.
Turning to weather, today we will have cloudy periods and a high of minus 8 degrees Celsius. Tonight, temperatures will drop to minus 11 degrees with variable cloudiness, and tomorrow the clouds are here to stay, and expect a high temperature of minus 10 degrees. I'm Sarah Ryrie, and you've been watching MediaPlex Live at 1.